I need to fix my eyebrows. They look ridiculous. Great start.
So we're back for another video, and we're gonna do a Q&A. And my name's Alyssa, and this is my girlfriend, Sam. All right, so let's get to your questions. First question.
Can you say a sentence in Spanish?
Say that.
Me encanta tetas. What?
He said, I love boobs.
This is what I'm gonna say. Okay.
Mi nombre es Elisa y tienes mi corazón.
What does that mean?
My name is Elisa and you have my heart.
Oh.
So cute. Boom. Who are your favorite artists right now?
Ooh, this is
okay. I'm gonna let her go because she knows music, I know movies, so.
All right. Well, I just saw Years and Years perform and they were really good. So Years and Years, Jessie Ware. I actually took her to go see Glass Animals the other night.
Good.
They were really good. So Glass Animals, The Weeknd, Broods, Tove Lo. What? The Fray. You can't go wrong with The Fray.
No.
Alright. So this is a sex question.
Alyssa gets really, like,
I don't like talking about sex. So I'm gonna let her answer this one. I'll just read it. What is the best way to go down on a girl? That was really hard to read.
I know. I don't know. Slow. Go slow. Start at the top. Work your way down.
Sure.
What do you think?
I think that you are great with your answers. I'm going to avoid that question. All right, this is from Off Key But In Tune. It wasn't anonymous, so thanks for not asking anonymous.
Mm-hmm.
I had my first kiss slash makeout a few weeks ago. I'm 18, almost 19. I've been dreaming about it since I was like 12, and I have to say I wasn't really turned on. I broke up with a girl, not for that reason. Do you guys think that I didn't enjoy it because I didn't really like her, or was I just bad? I'm assuming always thought I liked more feminine girls, and she was pretty butch. Thanks.
I mean, maybe like it has to like click with someone.
Yeah.
Like it doesn't matter. Like I don't know. Like I've kissed people that like it just didn't like work. Like it just didn't work out. Like I just didn't feel connection. So it. It's not that they were a bad kisser or I'm a bad kisser. It was just the fact that it just didn't feel right.
A first kiss or a kiss in general tells you a lot about
first kiss.
The person and if you're going to like them.
Mm-hmm.
And do you think that it's going to go somewhere? So, you know, it could have just been the kiss. It could have been the person. It could have been you. It could have been a number of reasons.
It could have been that you just had high expectations and you didn't feel like it met them.
Yeah. And if you like more feminine girls and she was, you know, too butch for you, then try it with a feminine girl and see if it clicks. But, you know, do you. All right. How tall is Sam and how tall are you?
She's a nugget.
You're an asshole.
I don't like you.
She is 5'4", and I'm like 5'8.5", 5'9", 5'9" on a good day.
I'm 5'4.5" on a good day.
She's a nugget every day.
Whatever.
How often do y'all have sex? What was the first time like? Any advice for a girl for her first time? But
that's straight.
Okay,
just
well
take
then,
regardless. Just take it slow. Take it how you want to. Go with the flow of the other person.
Yeah, go with them. Go with you.
Do what feels right.
You can't. I don't think you can give advice on like the first time, except for like whatever happened is gonna happen. I can't just be like this is like strictly what's gonna happen or whatever. Mm-hmm. I think. It just happens.
Yeah. And it's different for everybody.
Yeah.
Everybody feels different during and after and before, and I don't know, the other person could easily be just as nervous.
How got a couple questions really about funny. Her, and because in our first video, if you haven't watched it, it's the girlfriend tag. I'll put that link below. But I said that she was from Massachusetts. Mm-hmm. But she actually lives in LA.
Yeah, I've lived in California for 2 years now.
Yeah, so we're not doing long distance. I'm not traveling to Massachusetts.
No.
She lives here. So the question is, how long is Sam staying in California?
Forever.
She loves it. She loves the weather.
Mm-hmm.
When do you think it's a good time to move in with someone?
Whenever your little heart desires.
Okay.
Asking that is just such a nudge.
This is something that, as I've gotten older, I've realized. That there are standards in relationships, and I think those standards are set into place to make people feel safe about the decisions that they are making in that relationship.
Just like a philosopher.
But I think that...
You gotta go at your own speed.
Yeah, but the thing is, like, is there really, like, a good time, a bad time? Because someone can be together for a number of years, 10 years, yeah. you know, 20 years, and they could still break up, and they could have waited yeah. 2 years to, like, move in with someone. They could have waited a month. They could have waited, like,
they could have just moved in
they could
and
have
realized
just moved in after
the
20
other
years,
person's
you know?
A
like,
slob.
And yeah. I think that, like, moving in doesn't, like, ruin a relationship. I don't think that... Yeah.
I think, really, it tells you whether it's going to work or not.
Yeah.
Because if you can deal with waking up and going to bed with the same person, like, every night, like, I think that you can be pretty set.
Yeah. And the thing is, like, I moved in with both of my exes, and look how that turned out.
Ta-da.
I broke up with them, and I waited for the standard of relationship timing, like, 2 years, 2.5 years to, like, live with them, and it didn't work out. So... I don't think that there is a time.
There's no good or bad time.
There's no good or bad time.
Yeah.
You do you, and fuck relationship standards. Boom.
What's that?
The last thing is the big surprise that I said that we have. So,
we have a very lovely surprise.
Do you want to go get the surprise?
Sure.
Right.
Okay. So, the surprise, so last night when we got, Moose, we brought her back, my roommate wasn't here yet, so we told her that we had a surprise for her, and she said if it was living or breathing, she was gonna freak out.
She's staying here forever.
Yeah.
Yeah, her name's Moose. Why is she so little?
Because she's a little chihuahua.
I'm sure this isn't a joke.
It's not a joke, I swear. She's staying. You get to see her every day.
This is Moose.
This is Moose. She's our little surprise.
Isn't she just the cutest? Couldn't you just pinch her cheeks all day long?
Moosh.
And be cute.
So if you want to see more pictures of Moose, or just pictures in general, we will put our Instagrams down below, and our Twitters, and everything else down below. And obviously we're going to be posting pictures of this little nugget. Yeah. Because look how cute her
how
face
is. How could you not just love this face?
Look at that face.
Watch videos.
Don't make it weird.
She's so upset.